at 11, you are looking at the man accused of making a bomb threat against Cape Coral High School today. Kevin Christensen is accused of coming to the school wearing camouflage and telling a student he was going to blow up the school. Cape Coral police used a helicopter to track him down in those trees. Thank you for watching NBC2. I'm Peter Bush.
And I'm Kyla Gaylor. We usually see these types of school threats made over the phone, so I'm sure this was incredibly scary for the students who heard this. NBC2, Sarah Mankiewicz is live and local tonight outside of Cape Coral High School. Sarah, you're talking to students who were in that lockdown.
Yeah, Kyla, it was a pretty hectic day. Students were telling me that their hearts were pounding as they sat in their classrooms waiting for an all clear. Cape Coral police say all this chaos,
it's not a drill.
Stemmed from one man. Sources confirmed to us that the man was Kevin Christensen. He allegedly showed up to Cape Coral High School wearing camo and carrying a backpack, then threatened to bomb the school.
I was very scared. My classmates were scared too. It had us nervous, and I was planning how to escape.
Brandon Jimenez tells me he couldn't believe his school was under attack.
They warned us, and I was like, what?
Cape Coral Police and the Lee County Sheriff's Office rushed to the school, searching for Christensen from the ground and in the air.
Everyone was sending photos of the cops and helicopters outside.
All while parents like Danica Crow anxiously waited to find out if their kids were okay.
She said to me was, Mom, I'm going to die. That's when she explained to me that they were under attack. active lockdown and that they were, you know, going into the process.
Words no mother wants to hear and no students want to feel.
Thank you, God, that I'm doing good, and thank you, God, for you guys, my classmates.
Thankfully, investigators never found any evidence of a bomb. For now, Christensen is only charged with drug possession, but sources tell us that police are working with state attorney's office to also charge him with disruption of a school function. I'm live and local at Cape Coral High School, Sarah Mankiewicz, NBC2.